Someone asked him, listen, how come you could say that none of them can harm you? The Lord showed me something about a revelation, and I really strongly hold to this. If you see a child of God has been harmed by the enemy, it's either one of two things. It removed the edge from around you to carry you through a test. Or either your faith in him was weak.
Yes. Yes.
And at that point of attack, because you didn't stir on the word, he was attacked because of faith. Move the edge because of lack of faith in God. I proved it. God showed me a revelation and then a vision. There was a platform before me in this vision. And as I stood on the platform, and he had me this, like it appeared to be like he was showing me something in an example. I stepped, but it appeared to be water. And as I stepped out in faith, I exercised my faith. I felt my faith raised to that level. It became firm, and I had the victory. But I took my foot back off, he said, nah, and put it in. When I put it, my feet was like shallow, and I saw it start to sink. And then he said, put it back. He said, as long as you keep your faith strong,
yes.
You have won the victory. Yes. He said, never let the enemy weaken your faith. And this one, I came out of that vision. I said, God, I believe you. I trust you. When you say, do it, I believe it. I'm not questioning it. Tell your neighbor, don't be wavering faith. Because if you study, the Bible said those that waver in faith is double-minded. And wavering in faith is a sin. So you will not see the act of God because your faith waver. And the neighbor stand firm in faith.
Stand firm in faith.
Did you get that? You get the revelation? Someone give God some praise. You believe in God for healing for your body to cancer? Who let that